Three tips to make you plank longer. It's called a plank for a reason. You should be able to lay a wooden plank on your back without it falling down, metaphorically speaking, of course. Your upper and lower body should form an even line. Of course, the longer you hold the plank and the more fatigue there is, the harder it is to maintain proper form. But try not to push your ass up in the air. As you can see, I'm nearly in a downward facing dog position. Great if you want to level up your yoga game and stretch your hamstrings, not so great if you want to build rock solid abs. On the other hand of the spectrum, try not to fall through with your hip nearly hitting the floor either. You don't train your abs this way, because you take away all the tension and put it on your lower back. If you've ever felt a pain in your back after doing planks and thought what the hell was going on, this is probably the reason why. To solve this, squeeze your bum together whilst trying to suck your belly button into your stomach. And please, don't forget to breathe once in a while.
Pro tip.
If possible, use a mirror to check your form and correct yourself if necessary. Do this until you feel comfortable doing the plank. There are two important factors regarding arm positioning: the width between your elbows as well as the angle between shoulder and floor. Try to aim for shoulder width between your elbows. Don't go too far out, unless you want to turn it into a chest workout. And don't narrow it down too much either. If it helps your imagination, you should be able to fit a plate with your favorite food in between. If so, great job! For the angle between shoulders and floor, it's easy. It should be about 90 degrees, which is, by the way, the exact same temperature your abs should be after planking for 2 minutes, because they will be on fire. Although it's not a mistake to put your arms wider forward, it just makes holding your plank harder, because your core muscles have to do even more work. But definitely give it a try once you've mastered the regular plank. And by the way, it doesn't really matter how you position your hands. You can put them like this, or this, or this. Whatever feels most comfortable to you. Your head should build a straight line with your upper body. Try to find a point on the floor in front of you and look at it, like you needed to cut a hole in there with your eyes. Don't lift your head up like this to look around, because if you do, your hip automatically pushes to the ground. Also, don't try to lower your head to look at your belly whilst doing the exercise. Yeah, I know, you're working on your abs and it's tempting to watch your progress, but I can assure you, those abs won't grow any faster just because of you watching them. If you need to check your form with a mirror, try to just shake your head lightly and position the mirror aside of you. Once you've nailed the correct form, stop looking at the mirror altogether and keep your head straight. Congratulations, you've made it to the end of this video, which tells me that you are serious about planking. Now, I want you to take action immediately. Don't be that person that just watches a YouTube tutorial but never executes, okay? Okay. Happy planking!